They say the perfect country doesn't exist. Until you travel Scotland.
Hey friends, I'm Haley Dasovich and welcome back to my YouTube channel where you will find lifestyle challenges, travel adventures, and tech advice. So, the global pandemic may have halted a lot of international travel, but that doesn't mean we can't have safer adventures on the road. And since road trips are all the rage right now, I thought I'd make a travel video about one of the most magical countries I've visited where road tripping is the only way to see this country. Buckle up, friends, today we're road tripping Scotland. There's so much to see in Scotland, and I have no hesitation in saying that you should visit Scotland at least once, if not 50 times. And the best part about a road trip here is you can experience so much in so little time. You can easily do an entire tour of Scotland in 1 week. Raise your hand if Scotland is on your bucket list. All of you watching! Okay, let's go ahead and get into the best way to plan and route your Scotland road trip.
Edinburgh will most likely be the starting point of your tour in Scotland. There is a larger selection of car rental companies, thus making it easier to get a better price. Renting a car is really simple in Scotland. Rates are on average €8 a day if you can drive shift. Renting automatic cars are always going to be more expensive across the board. Beware, traffic in all of Great Britain is left-sided, so I must say that took me some time getting used to. Once you pick up your car, head into Edinburgh and you'll want to spend at least 2 days there. When I was looking for a place to stay in Edinburgh, I made sure that there was parking at my stay and I wanted to be as close to the city center as possible. Since I was traveling solo, I booked a single bedroom in an Airbnb and from there I walked all over the city. Make sure to bring your walking shoes because this is certainly a city you explore on foot. Strolling through Edinburgh is like a time warp and is by far one of the coolest medieval cities in all of Europe. There are so many cool and unusual things to do in Edinburgh that I could almost make a separate video on just that. While you're walking around the city, you will of course learn the landmark sites, like the Edinburgh Castle. Carlton Hill has incredible views of the city and it's a gorgeous park on top of the hill. The hike up Arthur's Seat at sunset is a must. The Princess Street Gardens. And from the Dean Gardens, you can make your way to the Sea of Leith if you want a several hours walk around the city.
If you really want to dive into the locals' tour and experience, I recommend that you check out Airbnb experiences.
These tours are given by people who are passionate and committed to giving you an excellent experience. I actually booked 3 different tours for myself while I was staying in Edinburgh, and I have videos from those tours, which I've linked in the description below.
Personally, I love Airbnb experiences because they're very affordable and you get to know the city from a local's perspective and you get to see a lot of non-touristy spots through a local's eyes, which is always the best way to see a new place.
After being bedazzled by Edinburgh, this is where you're going to be starting out on your road trip around the country. There are several routes that all work for a round trip, and which one you choose depends on how much time you have and what you want to see. From Edinburgh, we drove to Stirling. It's about an hour away, and you can make this a stop on your way to Glencoe. Stirling plays an important part in Scottish history because here is where the Battle of Stirling Bridge took place, where William Wallace, aka Braveheart, outwitted a much larger English army and claimed his place as Scotland's national hero in the year 1297. We stopped in to walk around the city and have a drink at one of the oldest pubs in the city. Just after Stirling is where your road trip adventure really begins. You can stay around Stirling or just continue the drive up to the Glencoe area. The drive to Glencoe is around 2 hours, but it's always good to plan a little more and take your time on this drive because the landscapes along the way are incredible. Glencoe is the beginning of Scotland's otherworldly landscapes into the Scottish Highlands. This area has been featured in the James Bond movie Skyfall and also in several Harry Potter movies. I would recommend giving yourself 2 days in Glencoe. There are plenty of scenic viewpoints and hikes. I hiked through the Lost Valley. It's a little bit of a rocky path, but the views and surrounding landscapes are worth the climb. After you spend your day walking, hiking, taking in all the views, give yourself a little reward and head over to the Clacaig Inn for some well-cask ales with a view. From Glencoe, you continue into the Isle of Skye.
All right, guys, no matter how short or long your trip is to Scotland, you need to visit this place. So plan on seeing the Isle of Skye.
The Isle of Skye, named Cloud Island in the Old Norse language, is the second largest of Scotland's islands and undoubtedly the most beautiful because of its dramatic landscapes. The island is full of mysterious moors, jagged rocky peaks, bright green landscapes, deep lochs, and towering sea cliffs. You can just feel the history and the legends as you go around Skye. There are many locations to see out in Skye, so that's why I'm saying you need at least 3 days, if not more. The best way to plan out the locations in Skye are to just save it on Google Maps. And one thing to note during your road trip is the weather in Scotland is unpredictable. One moment, it can be sunny blue skies, and then suddenly the clouds will come in and burst open with gale force winds. So I stayed at a bed and breakfast in Portree for 3 nights and 4 days. If you guys want more in-depth information about the sights to see and where I stayed in Skye, I've linked my videos below and right here on the screen for you. For now, I'll give you the highlights of places I was able to hit in 4 days. This land is straight magical. Seemingly untouched by the modern world, you will be drawn in and never want to leave. So when you plan your trip to Scotland, make sure you give yourself enough time in Skye. So after your trip to Skye, depending on how many days you have, here is where you can split off and drive to the northern areas. Unfortunately, I didn't have enough time to make my way up north, so from Skye, I made my way to Inverness. From Portree to Inverness is a 2 to 3 hour drive. There are a few stops you can make on your way from Skye to Inverness. You'll be passing Scotland's most famous loch, Loch Ness, where, I'm sure you already know this, there have allegedly been sightings of a sea monster dating back to the year 565. The road along Loch Ness is a long and skinny stretch up to Inverness, and halfway up this pass is Urquart Castle. This is the most scenic spot to view Loch Ness, and the prime location to spot Nessie if you're lucky. Urquart Castle is definitely worth the stop to walk around this stunning location with the loch as the backdrop. Inverness is Scotland's Highland capital, and depending on your road trip route, can be a jumping off point to see the rest of the Scottish Highlands. Inverness is a fairly typical Scottish city with beautiful stone buildings and old churches, narrow streets, and plenty of pubs and nightlife. The city has a gorgeous setting with the hills of the Highlands rising up all around it. I was in Inverness for 2 nights and spent the days walking along the River Ness with the occasional pub stops. From Inverness, again, depending on how much time you have, you can continue on to explore the eastern side of Scotland. I drove on from Inverness to Aberfeldy and ended my Scotland road trip at the Dewar Distillery for a few days of whisky tasting and outdoor activities canoeing on the lake. Those videos are also linked below and right here on screen if you want to learn more about Scotch and Scotch whisky tasting tours. Overall, I spent 10 days in Scotland, and I would have spent more had I known how much I would fall in love with this country. If you want to feel like you've entered a different world, I recommend you add a road trip in Scotland as your next adventure.
So all of you guys watching, have any of you guys visited these sites in Scotland? And just curious, are any of you watching from the UK? It was interesting, while I was in Scotland, I had met a lot of Scots who had never really traveled around the country. So any of you guys watching, whether you're in England, Ireland, Scotland, this video is for you. Hopefully this inspires you guys to get out on your road trips and see some of the most beautiful parts in the world where you are. And this is also for everyone else, once it's safe for all of us to feel like we can travel again and go out and explore. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for being here. Please comment below all of your comments. And if you have not yet, please hit that subscribe button. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Until next time, take on the world.